Madras High Court asked the government to respond to a plea to suspend the SP and the collector over the Paramakudi police firing case. After land-grabbing, DMK heavyweight Punmudi comes under the DVAC scanner. Over suspected disproportionate assets, the DMK cries foul. The CPM sets sail with the captain for civic body elections. Comrades are offered mayoral seats of Vellore and Coimbatore. In a freak accident in Tiruvallur, a truck loses control and rams into a tea shop, killing three school children. Nowhere to walk, spare a thought for the city's pedestrians. It's the curious case of missing pavements. A very good evening. You're watching Headlines Now with me, Ashmit. Those were the top stories from around the city and from your around the state. Time now for top developments that are pouring in from across the nation. No more pesky calls and SMSs from telemarketers from today, but the new rules also restricts you from sending more than 100 SMSs. The US tones down its attack on Pakistan. They say that they are confident of working with the government despite their alleged links to the Haqqani network. Goa Chief Minister Digambar Kamath faces an internal revolt over the mining scam. He says he has done no wrong. An SRK on what he'll do if his Diwali blockbuster, Ravan, fails. First up, in the latest from the Paramakudi firing case, the Madras High Court today heard a PIL seeking the suspension of seven government officials, including the Ramanathapuram collector and superintendent of police. Now, the petitioners argued that the police was responsible for creating unrest within the locals. They also challenged the police action, terming it barbaric. They also alleged violation of human rights. Now, after hearing the pleas, the Madras High Court slapped a notice on the government and the DGP, seeking a reply within 2 weeks' time. Now, just to remind our viewers, on the 11th of September, the arrest of Dalit leader John Pandian infuriated the locals. The situation turned violent as angry mobs attacked the police forces. Now, to rein in the situation, the police is reported to have fired at the mob, which resulted in six deaths. Now, after the attacks, the police forces maintained that the action was taken to tackle the angry mob. In fact, even the chief minister had issued a statement that the police forces had acted in self-defense. Now, in other developments, after facing land grab charges, DMK's senior leader Punmudi is again on the radar of the law and order agencies. Now, the Directorate of Vigilance and Anti-Corruption, or DVAC, conducted an inquiry against Punmudi, former Minister for High Education and Mines, for accumulating wealth disproportionate to his known sources of income while he was the state minister. Now, sources from DVAC say that since a prima facie case of cognizable offence was made out, a case under Prevention of Corruption Act was registered against K. Punmudi. Now, the investigators from Vigilance Department say that as an essential part of the investigation, raids were conducted at 20 places in Chennai, Cuddalore, Viluppuram and Puducherry. Now, meanwhile, from our sources, we have learnt that the DMK has slammed the raids, calling it a witch hunt.
தொடர்ந்து நாங்கள் சோதனை இட்டு கொண்டே இருக்கிறோம், இன்னும் கைப்பற்றல.
எவ்வளோ பேர் சார் வந்துருக்கீங்க? எவ்வளோ பேர் வந்துருக்கீங்க?
எவ்வளோ பேர்
எத்தனை
டோட்டலாக அது கணக்கு எல்லாத்தையும் இங்கே ஒரு ஆறு பேர்
வந்துருக்கோம்.
பத்து பேர்.
And well, even as the last day for filing of nomination nears, the Congress is in a tight huddle formulating the final list of contenders. Now, today is the second day of the brainstorming session where various candidates are being considered. Now, the party is expected to announce the names of contenders later this evening. And now, the meeting is being chaired by party in charge in the state, K.B. Krishnamurthy. Congress heavyweights such as Thangabalu, G.K. Vasan, E.V.K.S. Ilangavan, Kumari Anandan and Jayanti Natarajan are finalizing the list of potential contenders. And well, after the DMDK and the CPM joined forces, Captain Vijayakanth has struck a deal over seat sharing with the CPM comrades. While taking on the polls, the CPM, in alliance with the DMDK, will contest for the post of mayor from Vellore and Coimbatore. The CPM has also been offered 25 municipal seats and 61 town panchayat seats. Meanwhile, the race for the post of Chennai mayor is heating up. Today, the PMK's mayoral candidate, A.K. Murthy, filed his nomination papers.
தேசிய முற்போக்கு திராவிட கழகமும் மார்க்சிஸ்ட் கம்யூனிஸ்ட் கட்சியும் இணைந்து நாங்கள் போட்டி போடுறோங்கிறத இன்னைக்கு உங்க எல்லாரும் பத்திரிகை நண்பர்கள் எல்லாரும் முன்னாடி நான் தெரிவிச்சுக்கேன்,
மார்க்சிஸ்ட் கம்யூனிஸ்ட் கட்சிக்கும் தேசிய முற்போக்கு திராவிட கழகத்துக்கும் உள்ளாட்சி உடன்பாடு ஏற்பட்டு தொகுதிகள் ஒதுக்கீடு என்பது ஒப்பந்தம் ஏற்பட்டிருக்கு.
Moving ahead now, an updates from the case of sexual abuse of a 4-year-old girl. Today, the Madras High Court ordered a CBCID probe. Now, the SP of Viluppuram district and the inspector of Kalakuruchi, where the LKG student is alleged to have been sexually abused by a woman teacher and woman headmaster, appeared before the division bench comprising of Chief Justice M.Y. Iqbal and Justice T.S. Sivaganam. Now, the bench asked the CBCID to probe the case and to file a report within 4 weeks' time. Now, the police, meanwhile, has managed to arrest the LKG teacher in question, Poshia. Now, just to remind our viewers, the mother of the child had filed a complaint with the police on the 3rd of August, alleging that the LKG teacher and the principal of the school had sexually abused the child. Well, steering back to the civic body elections, the Tamil Nadu State Election Commissioner S. Iyer today convened an all-party meeting here in Chennai to discuss on local body elections due on October 17th and 19th. Now, ruling AIADMK, DMDK, DMK, Congress, PMK, the left parties and finally the BJP expressed their views at the meet, requesting the Election Commission to ensure smooth conducting of polls. CPM urged the Election Commission to curb cash for votes. Meanwhile, the DMDK, the DMK and the PMK requested the Election Commission to declare results of the Trichy by-polls after the local body elections. Now, in some tragic news from the districts now, a freak accident in Tiruvallur today claimed the lives of three pre-university students. Now, the three school children were having lunch at a tea stall when a lorry lost control and rammed into the wall of the tea shop. Now, the victims were rushed to the Stanley General Hospital. The students have been identified as Mumuswami, Mohan Das and Rajkumar.
திருவள்ளூர்ல இருந்து
Well, up on the other side, the Prime Minister returns to a house in disarray with the 2G scam threatening to dislodge the grand old party. Latest updates on the other side.